He may be the king of his own discipline, but if his wrestling is anything like his incompetent officiating, he's going to be at the bottom of the pack in the WWF.
Well, we've got an eight-man tag team matchup here. Eight stars in the AAA organization. This match will be competed under AAA rules, meaning that tags are not necessary.
And we're in America. Why can't we play by our rules?
Making their way down the aisle with a total weight of 680 pounds, the team of Venom, Supernova, Ludxor, and Discovery, Los Cadetes del Espacio.
Ross, you know why all these guys are wearing masks?
Ain't got a clue.
They still haven't apprehended those Mexican bandits that smuggled the hepatitis A-tainted strawberries across the border directly to our school lunch programs.
You think these guys are strawberry smugglers? I doubt that.
I hate to say it, but they found fecal matter in those strawberries, so I just wonder how they were smuggled across.
Well, it's going to be Supernova in the blue and Maniaco in the black with purple trim. Maniaco with the advantage here.
Come on, Ross. You're the play-by-play guy. Call it. That was a punch.
Nice shoulder block there. Well, I choose not to use that particular kind of language here. I've turned over a new leaf, you know. Hard chop there. Supernova. Got it right down his face. Somebody's going to put on their face Monday on Raw is War. You know, Ken Shamrock's going to have a no-holds-barred fighting exhibition Monday on Raw. And I tell you, folks, I've seen a lot of those Ken Shamrock fights. They're not for the weak at heart, shall we say.
I question the competition he's been in there with. Some of these guys look like they just came from happy hour at Lucky's Tavern, rolled in off the street.
Supernova. Up and over, Maniaco. Eight-man tag action, no tags necessary. So we'll try to do a little justice in this matchup, but it's very difficult with all the unique maneuvers and with us not seeing this particular style that often. And right there all the way to the post, that was pretty easy to call. Maniaco touches the steel.
Well, speaking of justice, Ross, I wouldn't have any trouble taking these guys into custody if anybody believes they had anything to do with the school lunch program.
Look at this move here. A punch into a headbutt.
Looks like Ace Frehley after pulling an all-nighter.
And now we got a tag made. Well, no, we don't. That's Ludxor and El Mosco. We'll get it right here. El Mosco in the yellow shoulder pads. And the aggressor now is Ludxor. You know, the mask of these Mexican athletes, certainly a source of pride, and more importantly, years and years of tradition in that country.
Well, you know, these futuristic costumes they wear certainly belies the fact that they live in such a backward, indigent country. When asked about these elaborate headgear and costumes, they didn't really care for them either. They just love irony.
Certainly not ironic that these stars are taking it upstairs now. These AAA stars certainly like to take chances.
Did you see that sign, Ross? Pillman is God.
I saw that.
How apropos. After all, I am the only deity in professional sports.
You're a real icon, buddy. And up and over, a twisting punch-up. A great move by Ludxor. And now we have another exchange. And we're going to see Discovery in the yellow. And his adversary, the Rudo, is Abismo Negro.
Quick translation, he's abysmally black.
And there's a spine buster. Folks, we'll be right back. And we're back on Shotgun Saturday Night. Eight-man tag team action in the ring in the green. Venom, his opponent, Histeria. In this eight-man tag match, well, let's show you what happened during the commercial break. It was Discovery in the yellow with a somersault plancha on Abismo Negro. In this AAA competed matchup, tags are not necessary.
Well, that's nothing new for them. They don't have to show their green cards when they show up for work either.
Boy, if you ever go to Mexico City, you're not going to be a welcome amigo. And nobody home there. Venom going up on top.
Well, these guys are great athletes. They know each other like the back of their hands. They know all the counters.
Oh, boy. Yeah. Hysteria sliding into second base on his belly. And look at the Venum. Venum on top.
Oh, my God.
The spinning plancha. Almost a corkscrew plancha by Venum. I think the athlete in the yellow is Discovery.
This thing's getting out of hand. That worm that's been shacking up in that bottle of Quavo's fixing to hit the ring any second.
Look out here. These guys are daredevils. These suicidal maneuvers are unbelievable. Supernova now in the blue. Does it really matter? Straight martial arts kick. And again.
This thing's insane. Reminds me of Godzilla conquers Tokyo. God rest his soul. Fujinaki Tanaka passed away, the creator of those great movies, this past week.
Great reversal into the head scissors. Folks, don't go away, still to come. Stone Cold Steve Austin has got a lot to say. You'll hear those comments.
I'll bet he does, now that Brett's in South Africa.
Look at this. Another somersault right over the top rope. Ludxor in there. And Maniaco paired up here now.
He's freely reversing the ropes here. Oh.
Rather an orthodox backdrop. He just landed on his head. No big deal. They're like the vicious chihuahua that just keep coming and coming. And Ludxor with an arm drag off the top, for goodness sakes.
He's going for a submission.
He's got a pinning predicament here. And Ludxor wins it for the Space Cadets.
Space Cadets.
That's what they call themselves.
That sounds like some of your past romantic liaisons of the past.
Yeah, but I'm a happily married man now. Folks, Stone Cold Steve Austin's not happy as he talks about WrestleMania.